So in this, I wanted to go over these transmitter units, the portables, which can be used as an alternative to the other ECGs over there. A couple things to note about them. Firstly, they use 2 AA batteries. There is no power switch on these. As soon as you put the batteries in, they start transmitting. Another is that each of them has their own ID, their channel ID. So this one is 2472. And that's important when it comes to using these devices. So for using these, you can wire them up pretty similar to how you would wire up a ECG to a patient. For this, I'm going to be using the patient simulator. And just like with the other one, match the color codes. And from there, you can put the batteries in and it'll start transmitting. Okay, so now I have everything wired up. And I have one battery in and one almost in. I'm going to show you what happens when you put the final battery in and it turns on. So now the battery's in. You might have seen the lights flash pretty quick. And now it's going to start receiving trend information from the patient monitor, or from the simulator over here. Alright, so now that the transmitter is transmitting, we can come over here to the central station and program in or tune in the portable unit to the central station so we can see the trend information. So I'm trying to select any of the portable beds over here. I'm just going to select portable number one. And over here at the corner, we have the telemetry channel entry button, or the field over here. So you want to click on that. You'll get the option to enter in the channel number. In this case, it's 2476. And it's going to be different on each one of these, so you definitely want to look on the back of these and make sure you have the correct number. It's always going to be in that blue box there. And then you hit the button here, and it'll say sending tune request. And from here, it'll start pulling up trend information from that channel. So now you can click on there, and it'll pull up the full screen. And it's pulling the trend information from that portable unit. So there are two different types of scenarios that can happen when it's operating normally. Either the patient has trouble and it starts putting out strange waveforms, or the telemetry unit stops sending a signal. And they both are interpreted different ways by the central station. So in this, for to start off with, I'll just simulate that the patient leads are no longer connected, or the patient's having an issue, or having a bad day, and they just stop putting out a signal altogether. At that point, the central station is going to start freaking out. We can mute that alarm temporarily. But when you plug this back in, you'll see the trend information start coming back and the central station will calm down. The other scenario is that the transmitter stops putting out information, and it is handled differently by the system. So I'm just going to remove one of these batteries. So you hear that ding, which means that the central station has stopped receiving information. You'll see this triangle waveform that's being put out, or rather that's being represented by the telemetry unit. And that's just in response to the telemetry unit not receiving a signal from the transmitter anymore. And that could be a problem with the transmitter themselves. It could be a problem with the antenna for the transmitter. But either way, once you put the battery back into it, the transmitter will start up again. And in a minute or so, it will start putting out trend information again. So from here, there's a lot of similar functionality you can do as you would for another ECG. For example, you can print the trend information as it's coming in. So I can just send this to the printer that's attached to the central station and telemetry unit, which will eventually print out the trend information. As far as I'm aware, though, at this point, there's not any way you can remotely view the trend information on an ECG. Generally speaking, these ECGs can all talk to each other. So if you have trend information showing up on this one and it's connected to another ECG, either another cube or even one of the older ones like one of these, they will be able to remotely view each other's data. From what I've seen, there's no real way to do that on the portable units. And so finally it comes down to removing the portable unit. And strangely enough, there doesn't seem to be really a direct way to do this other than discharging the patient or transferring the patient. So up here in, if you click on the, one of the beds, for example, you'll get this main window. Apologies for recording the screen. There's unfortunately not really a good way I can do a direct screen capture on this, so I have to use a camera. But when you open this up, it'll show you three tabs at the top. Patient info is the one you're looking for. This is also where you go to tune the channel, but it's also where you go to make changes to that patient or admit or discharge them. To fully remove the transmitter unit, the only way I've found really to do it is to fully discharge the patient. I think what you could probably do is if you had another ECG set up, you could transfer them to another bed, because from here you can transfer this patient from one screen to another. So I just transferred it from portable one to portable two. So presumably you could transfer them from portable to an actual bed unit. But in this case, what we want to do is just discharge the patient. Discharge. It couldn't really see it there, but it sent the detune request. And now the portable unit is no longer tuned into the central station. So I can remove power from the simulator and nothing's going to happen over there.